that Chicago team, when you look at, I remember when they made the deal with Columbus and they got an Eastamoff. I said to Mike Kitchen, who coaches them, assistant to Joel, I said, Kitch, I love an Eastamoff. He's going to be a player. They got an Eastamoff and a guy named Paterin from Russia, and now they've got another line. They've got Kane and Eastamoff and Paterin. They're outscoring the Taves line with Hossa and whoever else they try to put in there. They've been lucky, but they've also been traded players in order to get Brandon Saad.
But they've also had excellent scouting, and I think that Dale Talon is the guy who changed that whole dynamic of how they put together their teams on a three level, like the team that's playing in the NHL, the team that's playing right under them, right?
Yep.
The farm team, and then their prospect league that they have.
Well,
and I think Dale Talon put that all in place because Chicago had nothing but issues for right after that team with Eddie Balfour and Jeremy Roenick and the little Italian player there. I always forget his name.
Well, Savard, was Savard on that? Oh, Savard already gone.
Savard was on that team, but there was an Italian guy, a very small player, but very fast, just an awesome, I can't remember, Amante.
Amante, yeah, Tony Amante, yeah.
Tony Amante was great. Brian Nichols was great. That 1993, 94 Chicago team.
Yeah. No, they had some talented teams. And now, the Chicago, whenever they think they find an Eastamoff, they find a Paterin, but they always go back to their roots. Keith, Seabrook, Taves, and Kane, and the goalie who I don't think is a goalie, but he keeps proving me wrong.
I love Corey Crawford. Sorry, buddy. I think Corey Crawford's the real deal. He's got a couple of Stanley Cup rings that prove that he's the real deal. But, you know, those are big, fat names when you say Seabrook, Taves and Kane. Those are giant, Duncan Keith. Those are giant names. Those are the best names in the NHL, buddy.
Yeah, no, and you got four of them on one team. Four of them. Four.
I mean, I'm telling you, I know that Phil last time, and I'm going to tell him again, I look at the Chicago Blackhawks this season, 2015-2016, and they look like they could win another Stanley Cup with their eyes closed.
Yeah. Yeah, they do. I don't disagree. And only because of an Eastamoff and Paterin, who were young, an Eastamoff 26, he was with the Rangers, but they're both Russians, and they're playing with Kane like they played with him all the time. They've got two explosive lines, and who else has that?
Well, but that's what you need, and they got two good goalies. I mean, Crawford's got in his resume some Stanley Cups, and the other guys played in the Stanley Cup final. They really have a fucking team. There's not too many NHL teams that can say that.
Oh, no, I agree. I think that Chicago, you, in order to win the Stanley Cup, you got to go through Chicago and come out as a winner.
Well, I'm going to tell you right now, and I said this last year at this time, I'm picking the Chicago Blackhawks to win the Stanley Cup again. I said that last year. At this time of year, Phil said I was crazy. You know, he read me this whole, he told me that the New York Rangers looked really, 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 really good, that the Boston Bruins looked really, really strong, that, last year we all agreed that Montreal, the only reason they would get anywhere was because of Carey Price, and we were accurate on that. Anaheim, L.A., the Blackhawks won the Stanley Cup last year. And I'm picking them to win the Stanley Cup again. And last year also, there was some people in our troops talking about the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Not me.
No, it wasn't you. It was Perry or one of the guys on that thing. But I'm just telling you that right now the most complete team, from coaching to goaltending, is the Chicago Blackhawks.
No argument, Frank. No argument.
They don't need anybody. They don't need nobody. And here's a team, they make a couple of adjustments, they'll lose one or two guys, and then they do exactly what you just said. They grab two more monsters.
Yeah. They've they've done some good drafting, and
it's because I think Dale Tallon deserves all the credit in the world for putting that team together and putting the ideology of scouting. You know better than I do. You were a GM. You were an agent. Scouting is the most important thing. It's like going shopping for your family. If you shop and buy the wrong things, you got no food. Everybody starves. Scouting is the most important person for a long-term commitment to the success of a team.
Yeah, I agree. And the drafts that they picked with Taves, Kane, Seabrook, and with Keith, two of the top five defensemen in the game, two of the top three forwards in the game, and a goaltender who holds his own in the top 10. That's all. They don't need anything more.
Well, like, it's very hard to make an argument. I don't give a shit who you're voting for and who's your favorite team and how many jerseys and how many caps you have. It'd be very, very hard to make an argument against the Chicago Blackhawks not having the most complete team or a team that is posed and positioned and pointed towards another Stanley Cup.
Yep. Somebody might say, when you say you pick the Hawks for a Stanley Cup, they might respond by saying, well, tomorrow's Wednesday too, Frank. Do you want to pick that?